NRG have prepped here. We talk about NRG being such a heavy oriented prep team. Actually, early on here, hold that thought for a moment. Ardis spotted four, and now no secrets on the way through to heaven.
No, NRG looking to silence this crowd who are boisterous today. Ardis under a lot of scrutiny early on, but actually keeps his composure, keeps his cool. Loud have a decent amount of space though, taking over towards heaven. He will be challenged here, and he has lost down. Zanek doing well in the crowd, certainly happy about it. But they haven't broken through towards the site, and you can see already see the rest of the map is starting to look heavier and heavier, cleared by NRG.
This space clearance is insane by Loud. They've almost read this ropes rotation. Might be able to isolate Somm here. It's got to be less to find it, though. Can Somm slip away? He's found it!
Beautiful. This should be indicative that this B site is now under pressure. Spikes can be planted, but again, Somm quite close by. Not going to give up too much space. Should allow for a retake to come into effect. Zanek time now.
Zanek has to hold the fort here.
Oh,
the timing on the reflow is absolutely insane.
3v3 now. Tui's holding towards CT as well. This is nice positioning from them. Really taking over one space of the map, but they have left heaven open now for potentially this build back in from Victor, but deep angles to clear and limited time.
Victor going to make his way down towards hell here. FNS still trying to hold on here. Actually, the smoke's going to provide a little cover, but the aggression should
nice
come back through heaven.
This is really nice. So they're putting the pressure on. They're trying to make this work. FNS is down. First strike for Loud here. Pistols theirs. First contact mate. Picked up. Lovely work. Good trade. Now heaven's open. But look at the extremity. A fight happens, but Loud still making this hyper competitive somehow. Scrappy in this. And Aspas does get himself the rifle twoies as well.
There's two separate one for ones there. Could be a little problematic here for Loud with less disconnected, but should be able to give Aspas some support. NRG are looking to creep through this smoke and spawn though. Are they waiting for a flash from Ardis?
Sure
no flash
what,
left, actually.
Yeah, what would be the ghost of Noid's waiting on it to fade at this point? Spike is down. Ardis beginning to clear towards heaven. Actually does catch one of the players with that knife, so Aspas going to be filtering back through, looking to try and support, and it's a shot and a half. Huge impact hit, and Crash is now a 1v2. Brutal. Out of the bonus, Loud. Turning the screws here, and Crashy's nose this time is dwindling, and it is a crossfire. If he gets one, it would be a miracle here.
Three Somm on operator too.
Ooh. Okay.
See how that looks. I'm down to find out.
You're watching the bearer pods.
Yeah, apparently so, but Ardis unable to even see, just knew the right place in the right time and sprayed and hoped for it. Flash finds nothing, but Crashy's is on the site, so Aspas has his work cut out here. Kalanzine with him. Stunning shot. Crashy's deleted, and the site's now open and available. The divide's going to keep them more than safe for this plant. And four players in the post plant with that operator in play for Somm. Going to be tricky to bring this into effect.
You have a cosmic divide to invest here. If they choose to.
Does Les get isolated? They're worried here. Actually falls away and finds a touch of safety, but yeah, he's cooked.
What?
Les! Victor fortunately will find it with the satchel, but it is still a 3v2. I still want to see them try and get towards this site. They know there's still going to be one player on site. It's Kalanzine.
What is that shot?
The Rocky comes through, but now just one. Aspas falls to the knees. And Somm going to make it there just about in time.
I don't think he's got it. I don't think he's got it. It's going to be
Mike,
so close.
It's so close here. Somm! Lucky as you like, and the boos ring out. They don't like what they're seeing here, but NRG finally stopping the flood.
He's calling through, trying to spot him out. So he can't hold this angle.
No, but he's got a second chance at life here, and Victor, wonderful timing to come over as the 1-2 punch. Aspas, he needs a frag here, and he's just not getting it. Victor playing the time well. Somm not relinquishing the angle either. This could be deadly, though.
Gap
closed! A Loud move in. Sights there's waving that Brazilian banner, and now the spikes will be planted. This is hard work for NRG, but that ult could help.
Absolutely can, but the plant is good for main. So Loud can reset on this. Look at the lurk from Les. Can he destroy the lockdown?
It's getting so tense here. The timing's everything, and he's absolutely done what is needed. It's game back on now. Where's that next pressure point build from here? Aspas! Oh my god, he's got one! Takes out FNS. The underhand flash should have blinded, but still going to find the frag. It's just Crashy's alive. Three players surrounding him. One up top, two to the right. 20 HP. The crowd getting louder. How does he do anything in this? Looks like Smoke's going in and away they go. Zadok and Aspas in unison. Som towards the back of the site, still holding his nerve. The site is looking like it's under loud control. But look at what Som's got. Still an opportunity here to do some more damage. The pre-fire, he's still standing. He's still fighting some kills here. But it's three against two, and the spike's going down. Crashies trying to lean a little earlier on this, but they're still so aware. Aspas, unrelenting in this, leaving just FNS. Allowed right out of the back of a timeout from NRG, stamping their authority back into this game. The seventh seeming so likely now.
Now just showing no respect to this operator. Beautiful. As well. Too easy to close things out.
In my mind, they are absolutely worth their weight in gold currently. Double stack towards Ramflow. A different look here. Crashies, FNS on the case. Oh, but Zadok, nothing could go wrong for this man. Just, oh my God, he got another. Crashies, decimated.
It's all a fake. It's the same fake as a couple of rounds ago now. Oh, Som, gonna have his hands full on B.
Som, he's overwhelmed, Loud. They are striding through this game. Confidence sky high, plant once again in. And I'm looking for that late lurk as well, coming through Karanzin. The positioning could be deadly. Fever needs it. Artisan Victor trying to work through from heaven now, but the ult's in place.
Seal the deal on this site and the round potentially as well, unless Artisan Victor can get anything done here. Information off the boom bot. But actually, the stun comes through. That's going to slow Artisan down a little bit.
Well, the time is dwindling and Tui's just thriving! Loud making it up to nine. NRG are folding under this pressure. NRG exploring towards A, but there is a deep hold here. It is less. And is this another read? This feels like it's been reading the NRG book, but Som has found value. Finally, a little bit of reprise after what has been a brutal half of him on the B side.
That's big damage, so.
Massive from Crashies. This is
what
the switch off that we saw coming out in one of those kind of stinger rounds, now finding value here in the buy.
What a combo, even with the snake bite on top. Look at this lurk though. I'll say the flank actually coming through from Victor. He's outside B main right now. Did retrieve that rifle.
Oh, unaware that Som could have been on the site. Good trades in Aspas. Venomous in heaven. 2v3, Karanzin and Aspas. Oh my word, Som's just around the corner. The smoke drops and Victor's there. And now Aspas, let's see what you got. Hometown hero, anything to be done? No! Clutching in the final round here.
And how aggressive to Lau go on the defensive side here?
Well, it's an all-in coming out from NRG, but Aspas with a quick execution, wanted more. Doesn't get it, but Zadok quickly swings. Lovely work between the two. NRG, though, still finding some value towards this site. Oh, Artis!
The fadeaway.
Nasty shot. Nasty as hell. But Som is the walking wounded here, barely breathing at 4 HP. Come off it! What is that frenzy?
There's no trade. FNS is tucked in.
Oh my god, this is...
He wants to bank on this position, Lauren.
This is... It's so all in. Do they check on this? Tui's the young player himself. So much pressure on this one man's shoulders. He does come through from heaven. How meticulously do they clear? It's all on one. He drops down, Tui's! All too aware, 26 HP! And we hit the four! And the new Brazilian blood doing wonders for Loud. That's double digits starting out in the second half.
SMGs, they're going to try and deathfall back onto A site.
Just feels like a swan song, though. Karanzin back by pillar, up towards heaven. You got Aspas, you got Less. Where is the difference going to come from? Right there, Victor. Good start. FNS, he does convert the frag, though. Did get a trade for Aspas, so not out of the woods just yet, NRG. But they are clinging onto this round. Aspas, he's falling up on towards Crashies. And again, Loud are just demolishing NRG. This is the best opportunity they've had in a moment's time. This is going to be 11 honest. You need something out of this world that ain't going to happen. Tui's tying up this round, putting a bow on it. Zadok thriving in this. He knows he's got him on the ropes here at 11.
Karanzin and Aspas waiting here. Four players on the other side. Contact made. Aspas, the perfect flash.
It's one and it's two. Aspas slicing through NRG. And their hopes being left in tatters now. Artis still trying to fight the fight for NRG. And they're biting on this. Does the spike go back through? Yes, it does. Artis immovable until then. Less catching him in the heels. And now where does that spike go? 30 seconds.
Crash needs to slip the net a little bit here.
But he has to find value. He can't put it all up to Som. He can't just hold this.
Problem being, Cowan Zine's a little disconnected. That might be the difference maker with Crashies slipping into spawn.
He won't even be able to clear Cowan Zine here. Absolutely no way. And the time now is the biggest enemy to NRG. Crashies, he may be able to take down one.
It's done.
But the time is all but over. 3 seconds. He can just watch the clock rot. It's going to be 12. Loud running through NRG currently. The closest attempt we've seen so far. But the economy is going to be absolutely tatty from start.
The other thing as well, you look at the minimap back in that round. As soon as Ardis gets that kill, they send three people barreling towards him.
Well, Sadak unleashing. And well, didn't go to plan.
Is that a trade?
Hey, you know what? We'll call it that. And well, we'll call this round done. Because Tui's has got three. On for the hat trick, doesn't get the fourth, and Crashies. Have you got it in you? You got 1 minute to play with here. Has a spike. Has a couple more seconds of safety, but those are dwindling now. What can he make of this? The flash, we'll note he's still on site. He's got two to try and get past Cowan Zine and Les, and the timing, Crashies. He now knows they've crossed the site. And he is petrified in this corner. Creeping closer to players. Crashies turns! And Loud are there! It's map one! Locked in for Loud! NRG falling to pieces in front of the sixth man here who are on their feet already.
A very one-sided first map here, a statement made. No secrets on the way in. No pressure actually returning here. Sadak will get caught by the Trailblazer, and NRG looking to collapse on that.
Yeah, Sadak's in a little bit of trouble. He absolutely is. Good trade from Leslo to keep this somewhat favorable, but the spike isn't going to be planted just yet. It is actually left a little loose here. That could be a problem. Does get back in hand. FNS and slip back towards site. No harm, no foul on that. And the plant should be coming in. That late lurk from Aspas will become a factor eventually.
But look at the positioning here. Two NRG players up towards heaven.
They've got to be so aware of where this retake is going to be starting from as well. Crashies denied vision, but tries to take a little step through. This is the alarm bot to put into play if he wants it. FNS considering getting close to the wall as well.
A late flank coming through. Aspas got to get something done here. Nobody on the side of NRG showing to long, though.
No, they're sitting deep on the site, but the wrong timing shown here. Tui's makes light work of FNS. Calls in the swing. Crashies trying to do what he can, but Les is certainly more right now! As Aspas finally makes his debut on the site.
Still no flashback for Victor either. There it is, just about ticking through. So on the back of the dog, does he decide to go for it? Yeah, he does. So good flash. A little bit of a dash, but seeing the dog, you now know there's two there. Turns the flash just fine. Now the pressure comes in, but Victor only gets one here. That's the benefit of having the double stack there. And Loud now just flooding the site. Less great pick towards it. Sadak finding someone now just crashes. Can he buy the time? He's so cold with it too, didn't even doubt it on the defuse. And that's a second for Loud before standing.
Might actually catch Crashies here, Lauren.
Timing is everything. Oh, and it's good. Backline dealt with.
And NRG have to commit behind that. They have to.
Sight is clear, fortunately for them. No stress yet towards R either. You can already see them starting to toy with the idea of applying that pressure back through, though. Utility's starting to be committed and a bit of somewhat of an overcommitment towards CT, but they have to get some territory.
Sadak does have the lockdown here, so could invest it. Yeah, he will. It's going to shut off a lot of sight, force them into spawn. Tui's going to be feeling the pressure here.
Yeah, dealt with Ardis with a double as well. Beautiful time for him to strike. Couldn't quite get away from it, though. Aspas still standing. Hold on, Loud. The tap on the spike. Less. Oh, my word! Beautiful work towards CT, and now FNS sweating bullets. Two players to stand up against him, and he crumbles. Loud perfection on the playback in.
Angle, the plant's going to come in.
but they have really very few safe post-plant positions. Tui's winning out. That's massive. Ult comes in. NLG want to address this quickly, and they do. Crashies takes him down, and the overwhelm is there. NLG holding onto the site for now. Finally, a player up to the good. Sanak still standing, but only for so long. And now Aspas in a 1v3 position, absolutely checked on. He should not be able to take a step out of here. He should be locked in. But can he break free? Goes for the Vandal instead. Victor up close, spots one, waits for the swing, but it's Ardis on the flank. Beautiful work from Ardis, heating up now. But they all come in. Gonna make this a little bit more difficult. Already bounding towards the back of the side. It's not pretty, but it's the job achieved for Ardis. Site control again. The point man is succeeding for NRG. FNS wants to make absolutely no mistakes in this. Gonna invest the ult, but actually, Tui's found some. Paint shell's good, forces them away slightly. Let's try to connect that spam, but not quite finding what he wanted. Swing comes in, Ardis fit to go down, and suddenly there's a gateway open. Crashies and FNS are sweating, they're worried, but FNS, oh, FNS! What a time to come alive! Three big kills of the Young Gun 2Es. What can you do with it? That's one, needs a second, one more second to
play
with.
The Hawkeye's gonna get him.
Oh, he's gonna be locked down, and Crashies is on the way. Knife in hand, he's gonna dice him up. Oh, in front of the home crowd. The boos rattle out and NRG close the gap.
And they tie things up four apiece.
Beautiful.
Even there, the only thing that secures that is Crashies lockdown.
Yeah.
Things spiraling out of control. And somehow FNS comes away with this.
How's he get
the
blind
shot there onto Aspas, and then
that.
I think Karen Zine's already 1 HP from the decay. So an insta-kill with that snake bite. Huge round from FNS.
Yeah.
And much needed, actually.
Idea. This could be a nice old knife in the back, but it depends on the timing.
This has to be. I was going to say, he's got to be careful of this pop with the showstopper.
Yeah, and Ardis is away and sends it. Luckily, FNS is by his side. Less with the trade and the swing, but that's answered right back in. So middle is actually somewhat under control by NRG. I'm looking for the backfill coming out, though. I'm looking at 2Es maybe trying to pressure that. But already, Sanak in trouble. Deleted by Crashies. I love this split. Identifying so much pressure coming through from Link. They've just faded away from it here. Ardis tucked on the site. Head of the ult, 2Es. Not gonna get what he wants out of this, and Ardis willing to challenge, willing to brawl out. But Aspas on the back foot now as it's a 1v2. Tap on the spike, needs to draw some fire, which it does. They haven't seen him yet, now they have. Aspas, oh my word, 9 bullets to play with, and a dream. Crashies down to 58. He has to swing, and he's got the fight. Crashies pulling NRG further ahead here. Finally, mid is next on the chopping block. Lovely work again from FNS, but it's Crashies to fall, but the site does at least now start waving that NRG banner. Some caught on the way out, but unpressured. Yes, the ult comes in. Flash to follow. And no commitment towards the site just yet. Flank is deep in the back lines from Aspas.
So he's going to get past the turret as well, so Victor has to watch this. The tap on the spike, Som. Not reacting just yet. The flash is perfect from Kaunzine.
Going to see something from him. That's two this round. Can't make much more of it in a 3v2 now. Victor and Som, what are you going to do with it? Les is standing and delivering, and the defuse in 8 stopping Victor. Oh my word! He denies it, goes back in. It's just frenzies as best he can. Defuse will be there. It's 5 loud. Just clawing in this final round in the first half.
Well, he must have. Crashies going to have 3 members allowed charging towards him.
Oh, Crashies. Overwhelmed. Outgunned. How much? Oh my god. Oh my god. He's gone away with it. That's so much damage already done and big information as well. Look at them. Les down to 22. Aspas 18. And it's a huge lockout for NRG. The crowd is silenced as NRG pick up the first here in the second half.
See how I focus that direction. Does it get cleared here with the trailblazer? Actually, doesn't.
No. Okay. It's just a frenzy, but look what it can do. Finds both players. Les and Sanak going down. It will allow a plant to come in, and a rifle recovered for Aspas. Hold on. Now that's it. That's the lockdown coming in that we were looking for.
And you almost didn't want to see that. Yes, it's fine to secure.
Aspas, he's thinking. He's actually
there's two in spawn.
Now Victor does get lucky. Oh! The timing on that snap from Aspas. Crashies is on the site.
He's sticking this.
Wait, someone, someone, anyone, someone stop him! Crashies! Right under their nose! Completely unaware.
The pressure's coming through on double door.
Gauzin, stunning work. So much impact. Honest and FNS, in the blink of an eye, considering the next round. Five still standing for Loud here. Difference for sure. Three players, though, from NRG looking to try and get back in on CT. That spike's not on the site until just about now. Victor even finding less. It ain't out of the woods just yet. And the timing from NRG is divine. Dropping back in, finding the challenge. And now just Aspas in a 1v3. Som's low, and he's found the first. Two more to go, and a spike to be recovered. He's got a lot of work ahead of him. Victor up above. Som on the site.
Well, the smoke missed.
Oh my word, 10 seconds. He's got to find one of these. Do he gets one? But one is not enough here, as NRG will break through from 10. It's 11 now.
It should be less resistance on site here. FNS got to be careful, but he actually finds a kill here. Less will trade it out.
Okay, but they've still got a good hold here, but Ashes' HP is worrying me to no end. 10 HP? How much can one man do? A little bit of spray. Oh my god, it's so close! They do get the blunt down. Spike's in. They've got the time on their side. Does Less stick around? Well, he can't now, really. Needs to back away with the rest, yep. Looks like the post plan will be set towards long. Now, G might be forced to respect this a little bit. I need a little pocket of safety. This will offset the timing by a couple of seconds.
Two nano swarms still. First one popped preemptively. And the Cove removed straight away.
Oh
now, this wall's going to be ticking away, though.
Crashy's going to connect towards Salak, and Som's going to be sitting on the defuse. He's going to be taken off. Dewey's Gauzin holding on. But Arn is still fighting as hard as he can, but the time has evaded him. It doesn't matter less. Getting Loud back in the game. They've found a way back through. That's about stepping closer.
Som's got to be careful here.
He could be the gateway to opening this round up. Som's in a lot of trouble, and he's dead. Aspas breaks in. And now they're just divided and conquering. Loud are getting closer. Another flash is good. Artis on the angle. Kalzine's got to be careful here, and he's decided to back away into the safety of the Viper's Pit, but bounds back out, sends the ult through and finds nothing.
Sends a Rosa.
Oh,
Salak's creeping in the Viper's Pit, though. FNS has to be careful here, he's getting surrounded.
Yeah, he's in a whole lot of trouble, he's dead, Aspas! Huge impact, two big kills, the site is theirs. And the final two players, Victor and Crashies, I don't know if they're going to stay into this. Yes, they have the lockdown, but is this the time? Do you allow Loud to get to nine? You've been allowed back on the site. Turret takes contact, Sadak now fully aware. And time is ticking, and energy are running out of opportunities. This one's done, it looks like. Already backing away. Crashes with... Oh, absolutely nothing. Aspas is on the hunt.
He wants Victor.
Might just be the prey. Oh, he's just spammed it in. Hope for the best. Victor will punish that. If he can stay alive, that's probably the best he's going to get out of this. Oh, they're shutting down. It's 11 HP. They're just around the corner. He's dead and gone. Loud and knocking at the door now. NRG should be worried.
Here, two Stingers, a couple of Sheriffs, a Frenzy for FNS. An awful lot for NRG to make this one work.
Not what they need on the site, but just on the other side of that
wall.
Good
to hit that, it's going to do a ton of damage.
50 HP, that's lovely. And the follow-up flash, so many players. Victor, fantastic connection though. Aspas chipped away at Artis, confirms it. Respecting the utility put down and actually taking them down to just three players.
Yeah, two upgrades.
He's got an upgrade, you're absolutely right. The Viper's Pit comes in, but do they check on Som? Are they even aware of the chance he could get here?
They can spam with the decay here, sorry.
Oh my god, Som, they have no idea still. He's just sitting this one out. The spike is to his left, and they are clueless. He will be dead here, but makes so much impact in such a little time. Sadak and Les, what are you going to do now? You're running out of time. You've got 35 seconds. It's all gone wrong. They got the spike back, though, and 30 seconds to play with.
30 seconds
Sadak.
Left.
Oh my god, he just about gets away on this. They are just passing each other like ships in the night, and the KJ ult comes in as well. Tap on the spike and spam comes out. It's Crash, he's finding Sadak. This could be 12. Less has got an NRG! Finally break the trend that Loud was running on. Sadak tested now. Caution needs to be given here. Less gonna find FNS. NRG not out of the woods just yet. Artis in a little bit of trouble, needs to respect that.
FNS was the solo anchor as well. So Artis gotta be careful.
There's so many.
Potentially be overwhelmed here. That's going to look for the pinch and we'll find it. We'll get ahead of this rotation. Actually, two members coming through mid.
Got a run.
Crashes all the way towards long, and that's the adjustment on the plant here. Great awareness from Loud.
Yeah, Aspas can really capitalize off this too. Yes, they know now the pressure could be coming through on long, could be coming through from Link. Tommy back up to be invested, but the flash again, how do you dig these players out of CT? That's the tricky part. I can see if there's any chance for a Som, Victor, and Crashies.
Less is repositioned here.
Spam, not going to find as much as wanted. Lovely shot from Crashies. The time's starting to really dwindle. Lovely hold from CT. Zanika 2 is beautiful. Crashies still trying to find it out, but again, you can't dig that player out of CT here. Dewey's is going to play to perfection the timing. Yes, Sanak tries to make something of it. A little bit of a punish on the way out, but not going to have it. And another step closer for Loud. Double digits made. They're up to 10. There's a stack. There's three players towards double door. There's a pop flash on the swing, and Loud send them packing. Oh my word, that's perfect. And now just Crashies still putting up a heroic performance. Oh my god, it's Reddit. He's absolutely Reddit, but he's just being melted. Oh my god, what an attempt. 7 HP is the difference. But it's 11 for Loud. One kind of back of pit, one secret. It's going to come in, should clear sight quite comfortably, and this should facilitate a plant.
Yeah, potentially, actually. Sadak going to get the lockdown off this, and they've got a lot of information on the back of the Reckoning.
Absolutely. Seeker's really just going to ensure that as well. Look how deep these have gone. NRG, this has to be a full-on retake.
If they try and run the clock down here, Sadak's lockdown could be the difference. But Gatsy is invested here. They're going to trade off.
Oh, my God. This is madness. This is mayhem. This is pandemonium. NRG are on the side. They're trying to catch him in the heels. Kalzin's gone down. Looking for more. Less denies. That's Crashies eliminated. Now they have to respect these ults. And now play begins again. FNS finds it. Less is gone. Four standing for NRG. And now Aspas, Sanak, and Dewey's. What are you going to do about this one? Som's on the spike. Whoa. And now FNS finds Aspas. Dewey's. He's still firing off. Oh, my God. Som tries to hold it. And he's still doing what he can. Sanak! It's going to be OT. 12 apiece. Loud, bring the game back.
Unbelievable that we've even made it this far.
How on earth, Mike, have they done that? Okay, NRG going through the motions, right? This is all clean, but this time not drawing any first blood. No chip damage done.
And actually, they don't even clear through to elbow, looking to potentially reset to a very, very solid long hold.
How does Loud get back into this? This time, they're now running with operator to handle, trickier to bring into this. Yes, they're clearing the back lines, but they've got to get a move on here. They have no damage achieved so far. So these first steps have to be essential to outcome. Kauzin slowed down, Sanak trying to clear towards the back of the site, and does find Som. That's the first bit of damage achieved. And now he looks with the tap on the spike. Next victim, FNS! Kauzin and Sanak, they're just heating up. He's pushing the wall. He's
Tui's
getting so close. Tui's is not stopping. They've got to try and get past the wall. And it's going to be Loud, surely. Oh my god,
it is!
He could not connect! It's 13 for Loud!
Oh, this ran out of ammo! He finds a headshot with the classic, but it's not enough!
Oh, this. Stay focused here.
Can Les do enough here to sell this fake? Well, Kamzin's found one. Victor will fall.
But do they check? Do they check on Ardis? They absolutely don't. It's one. He's seen a second. He knows he's got a second here. But those seconds are dwindling, and he's got to make... Oh,
Ardis!
The myth himself is coming alive, but Sanak wants to deny it. Quell that pressure. Oh my god, you cannot turn your back on Ardis here. It's a 3v2. Less than Sanak, 12 seconds. Time is fading in front of them. 10 seconds out left. He's got another, and now a 1v2. Crashies and FNS up against the man himself, Sanak. He spots one, it ain't enough. NRG carry on the series.
Aspas with the operator though. We'll find one, picks up Crashies. And he sees nothing behind it.
Yep. Big info here. But still site success to some extent for NRG. But it's FNS actually to claim Tui's. And Ardis this time decides to get a little further ahead. Stunner of a shot coming out. Makes it away for now. The spike now in their side. Less Kalzin and Aspas. This is a brutal retake now to pull off.
And
two towards long. Two
Aspas still,
on
has the operator. Potential here to swap out a weapon. No, I don't think he can.
No. A little too far away, maybe towards CT if he was trying to get one, but now the time's really starting to work against him. Ardis, he is coming alive in OT. Two kills already. FNS takes the next point of attention. The utility's coming in, and NRG demolishing Loud here.
Ah, oh, this has got an operator. Oh. He's looking really mix things
here
up. He's towards double doors right now.
And that was a pressure point. It was a big pressure point. Kawazin on the
door. He's got one.
Quick as lightning. Oh, this strikes and Kawazin's down. NRG are dragging this game into the third. Three more bodies to locate and put in a body bag. Dewey's less than Aspas. Try and make something out of this.
NRG previously have done so well at converting these rounds with a man advantage. They drift into a much deeper hold here on A site. They're going to explore B main. That should open things up for them. Stuck behind this alarm bot now. And that's the green light. Artis going to make his way back towards A now. Yeah, a double flank coming through.
Crash, he's just falling away at the right time still. Not overstaying his welcome, keeping cool in this. You don't want to give them opportunity. When Aspas is still standing, there's still always a chance.
And a key molly just to slow things down here, Adsley. To buy time for this flank.
You need one of them to find big impact here, Mike. Aspas, this has to be everything, and F&S sends him away. Less than Dewey's for Victor. Oh, it's perfect. And we have to go the distance. Surely Dewey's trying everything he can. He's got so much more work to do, and it ain't gonna happen. This game demanded it. It deserved a third, and we're going the distance. Fracture now on the horizon. I cannot wait.
What a map here on Pearl.
Only one of these two can carry on forward. Brazil's hope placed with Loud and NRG getting overrun. Instantly, Kawazin and Aspas break down Som and Artis and draw first blood.
That's a pinch is perfect as well. The fault line, so precise. A double flank coming through from Bridge, but Tui's on hand for the first and the second.
On.
It's a Prime Gaming flawless to kick things off here on Fracture.
Nothing too out of sorts thus far.
It should catch both, actually.
Yeah, that actually probably will. They're in a whole lot of trouble. Yeah, they are in dire straits. F&S, actually, it's Victor on the swing that found the perfect timing to try and back him up just as F&S fell. He did manage to get the punish, but Less swings up towards tower. This plant does go in and safe to back away. 3v3 post-plant now. Tui's, though, going to catch Crashies. How the hell did Tui see him then?
Seeing something we don't, that's for sure. Artis now, a 1v3 once again. Can he get anything done here? Gotta consider just holding on to this rifle. But he wants another stab. We'll spot out Kawazin. That should force Loud a little deeper here. The fault line will catch.
Oh, sharp still. But I think he knows his days are numbered if he sticks around. Yeah, time to try and peel away from this. Stuck around long enough to take one with him, but still. This pace from Loud is good, and you've got to say, for me, once again, Tui's, what an outstanding addition. Oh, this lovely stuff still. Keeping hold of the rifle, taking him away. You can at least see the aggression on the test here. But Aspas exploding towards sight. No Som on the way through, but by now the spike's actually being safely ferried through. Kawazin going to get a plant, very unorthodox thus far. Sadak might get the next layer of contact just around the corner. Great timing and completely unaware. NRG seems so out of it.
You hear this drop as well. Crashy's isolated but still finds one.
It's still a 2v3, it's possible.
Crashy's has the Rolling Thunder. They're both coming from the same side.
Oh, but Artis really heads up played still just have that diligence in case Aspas was lingering. Dewey's, do they catch him? Yes, they do. But how do they clear that? Or do they even have the time for this? Going to just start that defuse?
They could stick it. They could absolutely stick this.
To defend this, Les needs to get involved. He has to try and do something. The stick on the defuse. They've answered back with a second to spare. First on the board for NRG.
Loud should have access to site, but they're hesitant.
Oh my God, Artis. Artis, turn around. Yeah, he's going to catch Les and send him to the Shadow Realm. Static going to burst on the site though. Loud should be able to get a plan out of this, but Artis on the way. The surround's going to come in. Sadak swings through, takes the fight towards CT as Tui's to succeed against Som. And now the push through again. Sadak going to double down on this aggression. Loud fighting for territory and winning it. And now F&S and Artis, what do you do? Up and above, Artis! Decapitates Kawazin! Takes down Sadak RG fight their way back in.
Lau can get a free plant and reset off it.
Yeah, they have.
It might be completely mitigated.
Yeah, and again, no pressure on the back line either towards A main. This is going to be difficult.
Yeah, they send it to sight. It's not going to catch anything.
No, absolutely ineffective this time. Aspas still waiting patiently as well. Over by Drop. Denies so many chance to get into this retake. As FNS the one to see it though. Spots out one, does not see the second already slipping through by Zan, but still up for the fight. Ardis being the tip of the spear, the defuse does begin. He's going to be putting his body on the line. He's going to be holding it down. Oh, lovely from Tui's though. And now just crashes. And he's seen Loud finding adjustment really well towards the A side.
Tui's.
And this is the man who could have it. Ardis and FNS now exploring deeper options. That's the first blood they needed. A double dip though, maybe overdoing it. Aspas evening this out, but Victor on the other side of the map, he wants a bit of the action too. And now Loud at the man deficit again.
This is exactly the type of adjustment I wanted to see. Aggression through B main here. And as soon as Loud feel that, they look to capitalize in A main. NRG this time around with three members to shut that down.
FNS is going to be told he has to be ready. They've already cleared through A main. They know that it is coming towards his B side, and FNS is the only one here. Does he just hold tower? Does he play patience? It might be the name of the game. They've got freedom. Aspas starting to wander.
A double flank, though, from NRG coming through tree.
But that's going to be a loss of life to Crashies. CT now
what?
Open.
Les found one!
How did Les connect that? Cow and Zine still on the side. They know where the final player is. Cow and Zine up against Victor. Two with utility still to play, but it's just the guns in hand. Victor. Second bite of the cherry, he's been tagged up now, it's the trade out. 11 HP on Cow and Z, the flash, it's found him. Victor trying to play around this, readjust to the side. Oh, he's got him! Victor is the victor in this one. NRG up to four now. And this mind game, this chess game is back and forth. So many ults to invest this time though. But Ardis is on the case. Oh, and he's walking on water, he's walking all over him! Two huge kills! Surely he's dead to rights, and actually, they got some as well. Maybe it's not over just yet. What can Victor do? He actually avoids it. But Sanak denies the ult in place. It's a 3v2. After all that damage from Ardis at the start, it's all for nothing.
FNS we identified on this flak. So, both Crashies and FNS, position known. Utility on the spike. Time ticking away. Defuse the spike. I haven't got time for this slow approach right now.
It's so hard to clear this. With the utility on the site, what are you meant to do here? They've just got to run through the motions. Loud, if they keep their composure, they should take the lead into the half. Crashies sees the first potential target, but again, time is against them here. Working it down perfectly. FNS is just going to try and sit this one as best he can, and it's actually off. Hold on, there was a chance and it slipped away. Loud at 7-5. We'll be leading on this.
So Sanak has to back away from this.
Sanak
just misses the nade. That could have been devastating.
Yeah, Crash is already down to 58. That would have been potentially huge. They get onto the site, the unhand. The time is actually good enough to catch one. It's a bit sloppy so far, a bit messy. Fall through by Zan. Cow and Zin with a trade towards FNS. That's fast. Taking it in the way of Loud. Stop. Stance. Cannot deliver. It's Cow and Zin. Takes down Som. And Loud get the gateway forward now. Cow and Zin by his side. Ardis and Victor towards that right side of the angle, though, already making progress. They might need to respect this.
I was going to say, now that they've seen there's a force behind this, Loud will back away.
Oof.
Big headshot, but Ardis can't close that out just yet.
No, but it's quite equal footing here. Ardis does find Cow and Zin. Crashies takes away Sanak from the equation. Sight's under wraps now, flying that NRG banner. The other two players who are over here have to respect this now, sit towards that sand side. Spike planted. Ardis is low HP, but again, you've got so many other bodies to get through to get to him.
There's no pressure coming towards main either here. Crashies might get isolated with the molly. Forced into a corner, but it's not. Yeah, it will catch him.
Oh my God.
Tui's has got it.
Hold on. It ain't over yet. The three players from Loud trying to work out the five that was against them. Now just four. Three step towards the side. Victor spots two. Comms going to be made. They've got to be able to support him on this. Where's the rest of the team? One by one. NRG are falling. Tui's tearing him limb from limb. But now just down to FNS and Ardis. And he was already low. It's only FNS.
No way.
And Loud do the unthinkable. There's a 3v5. But the individuals from NRG just get torn asunder.
No.
Precarious, dangerous. Waiting coiled like a viper. Oh my God, waiting to strike. Takes out Ardis, takes up the head of the beast. And now energy working with far less than before. The rest of Loud slip away slightly, not too far. Still wanting to hold that A main control.
Victor found space on Dish though. That should give Crashies an opportunity to get across the site. Does he spot this out though?
I don't think he's seen Victor. FNS did find Sadax, so still winning the fight over by main. The pressure, whether or not they expect it, is going to be coming through by Sanders. Tui's expect this. Yes, Kalzin turns well enough to get the trade at least. Kalzin now locked in between.
Big ultimate.
Watch out, place. No!
Look at the kill!
A quiet performance from Son, but when he needed it, he finds it. FNS already tenderized earlier on, down so low. Good trade for Son. And the 1v2, Aspas needs a rifle, gets it. But the ults are there. Som and Crashies both have round-saving ultimates if called upon. Som trying to play safety. Aspas gives away position, trying to check as he goes. And the players will hold. A good crossfire here draws the attention on one side. Crashies digging deep now for NRG. They are not out of this game yet. How much did they put to this? Oh, my God. Oh, the flash is gorgeous from Victor. Opens up the A site, but will they expect the one player still here? Aspas, no, he's got one. How long can he stand here and try and take the fight? He takes one with him. He's doing everything he can. It is a 3v2 though, and less than two. He's still so much work to achieve. The ult is ready though, buying seconds here. The lockdown considered, I think. Rolling Thunder gonna come back in, buying a couple of precious seconds, and the plant now attempted. There's the lockdown. Plant will not be denied by this, but that will deny the ult.
And a trade-off of ultimates here, and it almost locks Loud out of this site. Two E's and less, still want to make a go of this.
They need a spark. They need something to ignite this round. Two players on site, one above Som, waiting on the swing here. There's going to be the investment of utility. It's done well. Two E's still going to get one. Oh, I thought he was going to snap to it.
Someone to have an over-delivery in a round. They need an Aspas round. They need a Sadak round. They need something to change the outcome here.
Because so far, the ball's starting to really roll for NRG. Less though. Gonna take a wind out of their sails a little bit. Let's get away with just a tag into the loving arms of Ardis. Good trade for Sadak. It ain't over just yet.
Showstopper available.
And you're right, but FNS gonna take down Kalanzin. Good, keeping even numbers. Aspas takes a right. Oh,
oh my god!
Aspas doubles down! Doing wonders. We said we need heroics, and maybe he's the hero they need! Loud! Out of nowhere!
How have they done that? What a ridiculous round when everything looked.
Could be a quick rotation from Sanak, but again, keep in mind, Spencer's purchase is not perfect. Aspas, perfect. Actually has a gap to work with here too. Now it is sent home, sent away. And he wants more. Aspas hungering for it, fiending for it. And Sanak still got his side. FNS creeps, oh, the timing. That could have been the death of FNS, but it's not over yet. Aspas is on the hunt. He wants blood. He wants FNS gone, and he's got him gone. Aspas digging deeper than before. This could be 12 on the board. Crashies, though, finds two back in. And now Aspas and Sanak still standing, but not for long. Crashies, is it all his to be had? Aspas getting closer step by step, but he's down so low. And time is against him. The chances are going as we speak. An operator recovered and he bows out of the round. This is going to be it. 11 to 11. It's all even. Pressure 25 seconds. They have to make a move soon. There's no other option to it. It's time to go. Time to fall in towards the side. Tui's. Is there anything that you've got? No. Overwhelmed. 12 is beckoning, but 12 seconds. It's all that they've got to get that plant down with nothing to stop it. We're in the post plant with five standing.
Still got that operator, but Aspas got to be conscious. He's going to find one. Crashies will fall here on the first peak. Loud are going for it.
But where's that next layer going to come from? How do you pry these players out of these corners, even with that operator?
Look at the discipline here from NRG.
Look at this dirty off angle from Som as well. Okay, one's dashed in. Victor ready for it. Oh, and it's perfection from NRG. It's 12 made, and the arena falls silent. He's pushed up by Dish. He still has a chance to maybe be the game changer.
No
the
dash,
difference
though.
Maker in this. No, he's just got to stand and fight. How much can one man do? Oh my god, maybe just enough to spray. He's praying for it. He's not going to get it. Ardis answers, another 4v4. Smoke in towards Sand, and they're going to try and burst towards this. Ult goes in, going to keep them humbled. FNS holding them back here. Sanic goes down, the trade comes out. The spike now left loose on the ground. It ain't out of the woods just yet, a 3v3. And FNS, maybe trying to slip through those smokes, but no, decides against it. Post-plant time. FNS, it's time! And the ult going to come up for the back of it too. He's just pulled so many problems in for Loud. In a 2v3, they've got to put everything into this or it's done for. Kawazine, he's trying so hard for his side. And the 1v1, FNS.
Oh my god!
Kawazine keeping hope alive for Loud.
What a round! What a round from Kawazine. FNS posts up a huge round from him to even get it to that point. I can't believe it!
Oh, this very active. Looking for a second opportunity here.
Oh, he's going for it as well. He actually might press that corner, but timing is everything. And already they're on the site. Sanic surrounded though. NRG instantly quelling the crowd, quelling that aggression. Kawazine less than 2E's not having that chance now to set up the site, but it's actually less to find Victor.
In front of a ton of damage onto Ardis as well, forced him completely away from site.
Actually got side control to an extent here. A tap on the spike to draw the first fight, but they lose it. FNS this time will not miss towards Kawazine. It's less than 2E's.
They must have heard that jump.
Centimeter apart, really. The spike not the focus. They need a pick. It's just too many bodies, and they're falling. NRG look pissed off. They look mean about it. FNS individually, huge impact. Site now smoke, they're on the way. Spike in the hands, making it through towards site. Plant's gonna come in, nothing to stop it, no utility to deny. It's down. Pressure starting to mount though. Trying to get away from the site just a touch, leaving Ardis isolated, but that's fine by him. Holding towards main. How do they break back in this for Loud? These seconds passing are heart-wrenching. Ardis with the first, Aspas! Finding the follow-up towards Som, it's a 3v3. Flash goes in, not able to capitalize really. They're stunned up here, but they still can't break through those back three less. Thinking about it, and now the time is to strike! He's taken down FNS, and now he takes them all down! We go again! It ain't over! Loud refuse to lose! And NRG once again must face the music and go back in! And the pace is quite quick. Making no mistakes this time.
FNS spotted.
No subtlety. What? FNS still good for a kill. That's obscene to me. Victor already considered. This time, there's potency to this hit. They're clearing the site early.
Eyes on Ardis. And let's find this kill on the flank again. No, Ardis has punished it.
Oh my god, and that's potentially a huge avenue open. Feeling surrounded. Is there any safety to fall back to for Loud? Time ticking, but getting ever closer. That's a problem. Kawazine burns alive! Som got it pinned towards default. Aspas tries to turn the flash, but Som there! That's the time for Som! That's his moment to shine. A quiet performance, sure, but the moments are hitting now with 14 made again for NRG. An attempt made towards B. Ardis springboards off the back of the knife, tries to take the position towards the tower. Less unrelenting, but will fall. The trade there for Sadak. And it's just mayhem towards the site. Loud is still getting bodies on the ground though. Kawazine!
Oh my gosh!
Holds the line! And once again, it's FNS! This time in a 1v3. A tap on the spike. No one wants it. Oh, they've done it again! This game is bound to go on! Loud, how many times will they do this? Loud is calling for support now. Feeling that pressure, and he loses! The smoke criminal flies in, takes out Ardis, and now FNS! No way, no way, he finally falls. It's a 2-for-1 trade. A 4v3 now favorable, make it more! Crashies and some insurmountable odds against them, but Kawazine in trouble. We'll get at least a tag onto him, I think. But he's still standing, holding the way back through here. I don't know if Som and Crashies can find a way back into this. Two on site to get past. They take the lead. Loud, back with the upper hand.
It's such a fast and furious exchange here in overtime, Lauren. Yeah.
And Aspas will be once again noted.
The switch up here might even be isolated, yep.
Counter flash, yes, but nothing to make of it. Tadak on the swing, it's Messi, but he will get FNS. He's actually crashes to find Tadak. This is a bit of a problem. It's a 4v3.
Counting.
Oh, what? Oh, oh my god! Hurrying a two there! He's made it possible! It's a 2v2! You can ask no more of that man, but two is and less. Up against Som and Crashies. Som's angle. Oh my god, he got
spotted in the smoke.
He slipped away. He's kept his life though. But they're both on the site. They're both cornered here. They only know of one. Dewey's looking for that jump spot, finds nothing. The smoke's keeping them somewhat hidden for now, and that time slipping away. They've got to get a move on. And the swing, the double swing is perfect. Oh my god, this game! It refuses to end. It keeps going. Go loud. Bring themselves to the moment here. Crashies, Som, waiting, pressure mounting. They're over by Sand already. They've taken a whole lot of space.
Crashies have found the opener. Sadak will fall. Loud have to find a response here. They're sat behind these smokes right now.
They have no idea about FNS. Look at the rotations. They're all in. They put full faith in Artis, and rightly so. He's holding now half of this map and surrounded, and the firing squad is called upon. It's Aspas gone. Oh, the follow-up flash is gorgeous. Good trade, but the numbers so favorable to NRG. This should be 16. Should be taking the lead. Les doesn't like that narrative. Oh my god, he's making damn good. Oh my god.
Oh, right.
Oh my god, what on earth is going on? FNS, breathe a sigh of relief. There's still twoies.
Got the spike.
He's got 40 seconds still as well.
If he gets the plant, he's got the orbital strike. Ardis reading this.
Yeah, he knows.
Can he catch him ahead of CT though? No smokes left for Tuiz.
This is just bold. Tuiz, hold your breath, try and make that cross.
Oh, oh my
what?
God!
The
He's
shot.
So aware!
Out of nowhere from Tuiz, and now a 1v1, and FNS is 4 HP. For the right place at the right time. FNS, get your gun out.
Oh,
oh Tuiz!
Word! What are these rounds?
You won't see anything like this again. And away we go, off to the races. Les, first fight lost. NRG are in. The site, by all rights now, should be pretty safe. We know it, obviously NRG do not. They still need to go through the list. But this retake, who's waiting? It's gonna be Crashies. He could greet them before the expected angle. He tucks in. Oh my god, Ardis goes down, but it almost plays into the fact that they still check. Yes, they do. Sadak, brilliant heads up play. Som, there to help him out, but actually, Crashies has fallen. Victor dives into effect, desperate to help him out, but backs away at the right time. Even just Tuiz and Sadak to try and pull off again the unthinkable.
Still got a smoke. 24 HP here. Sadak has to lead the charge for Loud. And NRG tucking in now.
Shot and a half. FNS big work. Safe pair of hands. Tuiz at 24 HP. Probably the death of him now. First player seen. Second considered. We go again, Mike.
G. Deal with the trap and they follow through it. FNS could be isolated here, Lauren.
Yeah, and he is mowed down into the blender. Sadak with the follow-up too.
Got another.
Tell me where. Maybe straight through the smoke at this point. Looking for a response to Crashies. Not gifted one though. Time to be purchased on the plant. Good utility there. Crashies willing to dive in though, but the second round is going to hurt. It's going to chunk him down. That's fast. Huge round. Crashies the only one alive, barely breathing. The walking wounded. And now to be the walking dead. Les closes down the account and gives once again Loud the advantage. Series point.
And the
deep breaths for NRG. And hold tight for Loud. 17 rounds by their name. The one that's so evasive is now, but the rotation, the timing on this is massive. Yes, he'll note the trap, but that's fine.
I think he's far enough away to updraft. I think he has.
Yes, he is quick to this, and they are sitting deep. Don't want to allow any of these picks to come in. NRG will probably get a plant from this, but they will not be safe in these deeper post plants.
Roll your minds back. A full 5v5 retake previously for Loud in this very situation.
The tension building. The plant comes in, and they question the discipline.
Tagged up heavily on the flank. He has to peel away.
He does. Now it's meant to be a big factor here. Sadak, though, isolating Victor towards CT is massive. It opens up a way back in. Ardis tries to give himself a little bit of a one-way to play with, but it's Som who's going to benefit as well. Les, ooh, the timing! Crashies find Sadak, and maybe it's all but done! Crashies and FNS, the last two alive! And they've got their work cut out to say the least. FNS
a close. Absolute madness. NRG giving it everything they had. So little to separate these teams today, Lauren.
The legend of El Clasico continues. These two teams providing some of the best Valorant you can ever see.